Today we are going to discuss chapter 9, reproduction in plants. Reproduction in plants, chapter 9. Here try to understand about reproduction. The process by which living organisms can produce more of their own kind is known as reproduction. It is a process by which living organisms can produce more of their own kind is known as reproduction. Here, parts of plant, flower, stem, leaf, bud, roots are given. Now, roots, stem and leaves are known as the vegetative parts of a plant. It is the flowers that are the reproductive part of a plant. It is the flowers that are the reproductive part of a plant. Flowers change into fruits which contain seeds. When seeds germinate, they form new plants. Now, types of reproduction in plants. Types. The method of reproduction in plants are generally grouped into two main types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction. What is asexual reproduction? An individual can reproduce on its own without the involvement of another individual of the same species. Here some process occurring. This is budding. Here try to understand this thing. Parent cell. This is a parent cell. Here formation of bud, division of nucleus. And daughter cell is formed. Here daughter cell is formed. This is budding in yeast. Do you know? Now do you know probiotics are dietary supplements containing potentially beneficial bacteria or yeast. Some probiotic supplements are the use the yeast Saccharomyces boulderdale to maintain and restore the natural flora in the human intestine. Now activity first. To grow yeast in a beaker. How do you get yeast in a beaker? You will take 100 ml of lukewarm water in a beaker and dissolve 1 teaspoon of cane sugar in it. Add a few grains of dry yeast available at the bakery shop or a chemist. Yeast cakes available at some bakery shops can also be used. Mix well and cover the mouth of the beaker with a lid or aluminium foil. Leave it undisturbed for about 24 hours. You will observe bubbles rising in the solution and froth forming at its surface. Take a drop of this solution on a clean glass slide. You may use methylene blue to stain the yeast cells. Cover it with a glass cover slip. Observe the yeast cells on the glass slide under the microscope to see the different stages of budding. Here you have to use microscope. You know it is a device through which you can see tiny objects. Microscope is a device through which you can see tiny objects, small objects. Now next thing, fragmentation. Here fragmentation in Aspergera, algae, Aspergera, spore formation. Here this is a bread and there is a spore formation. This is bread mold. Now activity two. To make your own microbe garden. Here you have to make microbe garden. But you have to caution, precaution. You have to think this is good or bad. You should do anything if this is good. You think, then this is precaution. What things are given? Perform this activity under adult supervision. Do not bring your face too close to the bread piece. Use a hand lens to observe. This garden will have to be carefully and properly disposed of in about a week's time. But here, disposed, you should dispose. Now, vegetative propagation. It means you have to use parts of plant, then there will be vegetative propagation. Now, first thing, vegetation propagation from a stem. You know, you may produce potato using a stem, potato tuber, you may bird eye, onion bulb. A corm is a short vertical swollen underground stem that serves as the storage organ and is used by some plants to survive in winter or other adverse conditions such as drought and extreme heat. Here, grafting in rose, you know this thing. Layering in jasmine plant, you may see. Here, vegetative propagation from leaves. Here, vegetative propagation in bryophyllum from leaves. You know this thing. You have studied this thing in class 6 also. No problem. Now, here given, do you know? Bryophyllum has the unique ability of growing small plantlets on the fringes of the leaves. These eventually drop off and form roots. Due to this, it has been given names like mother of thousands, mother of millions. It means many plants arises from this. And so, Bryophyllum has given several names. You may see this thing. Now, roots, vegetative propagation from roots. Sweet potato, dialar tuber, etc. produces through vegetative propagation from roots. Now, sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, what is sexual reproduction? Requires the involvement of two individuals, typically one of each sex. Here, parts of flower, you have drawn several time parts of flower in class 6. In project also, it is given to draw a parts of flower. So, there is no problem. Now, next thing, do you know here also? Do you know Rafflesia? You know Rafflesia is a largest flower in the world. Rafflesia belongs to a group of parasitic stemless, leafless plants with a distinctive putrid odor. The plants are native to Malay archipelago and Indonesia and live on the stems and roots of certain woody vines. The large pink five-lobed flowers are pollinated by carrion flies. The blossom of one species, the corpse lily, is recognized as the largest flower in the world. It grows up to 91 cm 36 inch in width with petals 3 cm 1 inch thick and 46 cm 18 inch long and weighs as much as 7 kg. Now next thing, unisexual and bisexual flowers. Try to understand unisexual flowers, bisexual flowers. Life cycle of a flowering plant. This is important thing. Here the plant dies, the seed germinate. First thing, the seed germinate, the plant grows, the plant flowers, The plant produces fruit, the fruit releases seeds, and finally the plant dies. This is the life cycle of a flowering plant. Now next thing regarding pollination. You know, you have already know this thing. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma is known as pollination. Pollination, pollen agents transfer pollen grain from stigma to anther to stigma. There are self-pollination, cross-pollination, etc. Now, pollinators in nature. The process of pollination requires pollinators. Pollinators are agents that carry or transfer the pollen grains from an anther to a stigma. Wind, bees, butterflies, and many other insects, birds, rats, and bats are the main pollinators. These are pollinators. In some aquatic plants, water is an agent of pollination. Pollen grains of some flowering agents magnified. Here, wind pollinated flower, insect pollinated flower, you may see here petal, stamen, carpel, nectary, stem, etc. All things. Fertilization. Gametes, fertilizants, embryo. Fate of the flower after fertilization. After fertilization, the sepals, petals, stamens and stigma usually dry up and fall off. Development of seed. The ovules from seeds. A seed has cotyledons to store food and the future plant, that is the embryo. Development of fruit. How will occur development of fruit? Now in this, do you know some fruits like apples are termed as false fruit? What things given? Apples termed as false fruits. Apple is known as a false fruit as the juicy edible portion does not develop from the ovaries but from the receptacle present just above the stalk of the flower. Germination of seed. Under suitable condition, the seed germinates to form a seedling that grows into a new plant. Seed dispersal. You know this thing, you have studied in class 5. Several agents through which dispersal occurs. Dispersal by wind. Example, you know, mother, seed of mother dispersed by wind. Do you know the sea bean has the largest seed pod in the world? It can travel more than 3 kilometers through rivers before it flows into the sea. Here it can float around for up to a year before it is washed ashore. Coconuts are also dispersed in this manner. Dispersal by water. You know this thing. Dispersal by animals. Dispersal by explosion of fruit. Now next thing, do you know animals as pollinators? The African elephant eats the akika plant and helps to disperse the seeds by shaking the trees. When the elephant eats the seeds find a fertile home in the elephant's droppings. The alpine nutcracker eats pine seeds, cone seeds. It also usually buries the seeds that it does not eat. When it forgets where it has buried them, the seeds there get a chance to grow. The durian is a plant that is really smelly. Animals of all sorts like the orangutan come to eat it. When it breaks open, all the seeds just tumble out. Animals as pollinators. Here in this page, keywords, asexual reproduction. Try to understand carefully, read this page and try to understand. Asexual reproduction. Reproduction in which an individual can reproduce on its own without the involvement of another individual of the same species. Here reproduction occur, reproduce on its own, that is asexual reproduction, bisexual. Through these words, bi, it means flowers having both a stamen and pistil do two things. Bisexual means two, a stamen and pistil. Budding, asexual reproduction by producing an outgrowth called the bud. Here there is outgrowth. What thing? Outgrowth will occur and therefore there will germination of seed, that is budding. Fertilization, fusion of male and female gametes to form a zygote. Try to understand fertilization about fusion of male and female. There are two members, male and female. Fragmentation, breaking of an organism into fragments which develop into new individuals. Mainly breaking occurs and therefore there will be fragmentation, twisting. Female reproductive part consisting of ovary and ovules. Don't forget, you are a studying chapter about plant. Pollination, transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma in flowers. In lower class, you have studied this thing from one place to another place. About pollination, you have studied this thing, transfer of pollen grain from one plant to another place. Pollinators, agents that carry or transfer the pollen grain from an anther to a stigma. Reproduction, you know, process by which organisms produce more of their own kind. Sexual reproduction. Reproduction involving two individuals, typically one of each sex. A stamen, male reproductive part consisting of an anther and a filament. Unisexual flower, flowers having either only stamens or only the pistils. Vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction through use of the vegetative part like root, stem or leaves of the plant. These things are given in this chapter. Try to read this chapter and try to understand all the terms given in this chapter. I hope you will enjoy from this chapter and hope you will get good ideas. Thank you. Have a nice day.